Olá, eu sou o Frederic, estou falando de Guaratuba, no sul do Brasil.
Olá, eu sou a Sâmia e falo de Belém, do norte do Brasil.
Olá, eu sou a Bibiana Serpa e eu falo do Rio de Janeiro, na região sudeste do Brasil.
Olá, meu nome é Marco Mazzarotto e eu falo aqui da cidade de Curitiba, sul do Brasil.
Olá, aqui é o Ricardo Arthur que está falando. Eu estou falando diretamente de Juiz de Fora, Minas Gerais, sudeste do Brasil.
Olá, sou Rodrigo Freise Gonzato e falo de Curitiba, no sul do Brasil.
This research tells the story of the formation of the design and oppression network in Brazil, to discuss the possible relationship between design and social movements.
Design and research is getting interested in social movements in recent years, even through uncommitted or exploitative engagements, such as social innovation.
Organization tactics like coalition building have been taken from civil rights movements and turned into operative concepts such as designing coalitions. Instead of pointing to the temporary union of different struggles, designing coalition points towards convergent interests. Designing coalitions in this way are trying to produce an uncontroversial design space with mild or even no contradictions. And the contradiction of oppression, which is so ubiquitous in this region, just becomes a technical problem to be solved by the other, not by ourselves. This is a very depoliticizing approach. Instead, we think that we can revise designing coalitions to engage better with the social movements in our country, in our place. Therefore, we propose to rethink designing coalitions as insurgent design coalitions based on the experience of founding and weaving the design and oppression network in Brazil.
Brazilian democracy and everyday politics is fraught with oppression. Under the nefarious specter that followed the removal of President Dilma Rousseff by parliamentary coup in 2016, Brazilians elected an authoritarian, violent, and anti-human rights government in 2018. This government discharged criticism over public education while praising private education.
The COVID-19 pandemic broke out just when the tension between public universities and the Ministry of Education reached its peak. The minister tried to force a rapid transition to remote education, but the learning infrastructure was not evenly distributed in the country. A lot of students did not have access to internet at home, a personal computer, or a common space to study. The federal government's inability to deal with this shortcoming followed the same pattern displayed in managing the health crisis. The sanitary impossibility of mobilizing street protests did not allow the formation of a popular front against the government. And the institutional politics failed the population by pursuing their own interests in bureaucratic agreements.
In this context of intensified social contradictions, the design oppression network insurged. The network was formed by design professors, students, and professionals from all over Brazil, as well as from other countries. From its inception, the network was concerned with the Latin American reality, colonized, culturally invaded, underdeveloped, and oppressed in various ways by the exploitative bourgeoisie, the male patriarchy, and the colonialist global north.
On a weekly basis, the network complicators, the opposite of facilitators, conduct a reading group open for anyone to join. The complicators also periodically hold live broadcasts on YouTube, participate in professional events and academic conferences, like this one, and promote partnerships and actions with collectives and social movements.
The network design decisions are collectively taken in specific channels like meta design and votações leiturias, which means the place where we vote and design together the network. Through our readings and accumulated personal experience, we came up to the conclusion that participation in design is by now the primary means of tackling oppression in design. It's not yet clear what kind of participation we want, since it is by itself a term that can become an empty signifier. At least we know that politicizing participation is a means to expand the design space beyond capitalist products and services.
The network approaches design as a pedagogical and critical process. So the design space becomes a space for listening, reflection, dispute, and synthesis. In a word, a controversial design space. In a controversial design space, oppression is recognized as a structural social relation that also manifests within the social movements and requires constant dialogue to avoid jeopardizing the struggle. Both Paulo Freire and bell hooks inspired us to produce controversial design spaces. While weaving out the design oppression learning community, we try to understand the diversity of contexts that determine and interfere in the needs, process, and consequences of the projects we carry out in different places in a very diverse spectrum of realities.
Despite the differences, we share the desire to create spaces for intervention in order to avoid uncritical activism. The transformation of reality is therefore a common horizon for the designers that weave the network. We understand that if we want to transform reality, we need to transform our practices to overcome paternalistic, capacitating, and excluding methodologies in favor of a design that is able to move across contradictions, recognizing differences and facing inequalities.
We can conclude that the Design and Oppression Network is a case of an insurgent designing coalition, a coalition of different individuals and collectives that join forces to rebel against institutionalized and normalized forms of oppression in society. Instead of dealing with matters of concern, these coalitions deal with matters of care, as members need to care for each other in face of intense oppression, like Lotério and Vamstel describes.
Design and oppression can be considered an insurgent design coalition, one that does not converge for common interests, but for solidarity across struggles. Actors do not coalesce for sharing interests, but for helping each other in their own struggle. Solidarity is a collective feeling that bonds together people coming from different social movements and helps them fight a common enemy, such as fascism. Insurgent design coalitions do not point towards an utopian distant world of many worlds, a pluriverse, as Escobar called it, but towards an utopian near future world with less oppression, a much more specific cause to temporarily fight together for. If design research aims at having productive engagements with social movements, due appreciation should be paid for its traditional organization forms. Instead of instrumentalizing and watering down these forms for design objectives, design should serve social movement goals. From our experience, insurgent design coalitions is not a concept abstract away from social movements, but a concrete lived experience of engagement with social movements in a careful way.